Hey, thanks. Thanks, everybody. Thanks for coming out on the school night. Skipping stupid church. Not doing the homework. It's like, I don't know, it was hard to explain to my algebra teacher how I only knew how to do the odd ones correctly. It just comes to me. Gang, I'm real happy to be here at the Pie Light. I'm happy for a lot of things. Happy to meet the Clementine Was Right folks, but a big round of applause for those guys. In the second rodeo. I'm happy that it's springtime here in Knoxville, Tennessee. Right, I'm happy to see redbud trees out. I'm happy to talk to the KUB guys that were trying to cut down a whole bunch of unnecessary parts of my well-sculpted chaos of a yard and tell them it wasn't necessary. I'm happy to not have to change clothes 4 times a day like I was last week, so far this week. Happy to have spent all day in one pair of shoes. I'm really happy, this is dumb, but I'll tell you what I'm really happy about. And it's not the sound coming out of here, but that's unavoidable, so who cares? But this fall, I planted winter rye as a cover crop in my garden. And it's supposed to dig down, and it's supposed to bust up clumps of hard soil and fill it with nitrogen. And so I planted it. And then I went to New Mexico immediately after Wakara, and we had a great time. And then we came back, and I was surprised that the rye that I had planted had sprouted because I did it so quickly and in such a rush. But it did, and so then it became great big and tall over the spring, and it was a foot tall. And so then I had to till this giant grass mountain that I had planted, hoping that it was going to fill the earth with nitrogen and make for a beautiful garden bed. And so then my tiller started, which is another giant praise. And then I tilled it under and it looks great. It's just a beautiful fluffy loam. You know, it's like, well, what is loam? You know, like, anyway. So I'm really happy that works and just didn't break every machine that I had. As long as we're being honest, you know, really, really happy about that. It's so hard going every day out to the mailbox wearing the wrong clothes. It's like, well, it's not that far, but it's really unpleasant. So I need to change clothes again. And then the only thing that comes are like coupons for Arby's and like D's. Like, does anybody here use, like, if you're going to Arby's, you're already screwed, you know? Like, it's like, you have agreed, it's like, I have resigned myself to pay $7 for frozen chocolate milk. So like saving 70 cents on like 8,000 calories. It's not your MO, you know? But anyway. Does anybody here ever use a coupon at Arby's that I don't live with? Yeah?
College days, right? Baby.
Well, college days. Right. I'm just wondering, like, who uses those things?
Team Arby's is over here. We had some opposition.
Not to disparage Jamocha as a thing or as an institution. Here's a song about wine that comes in a bladder inside a box. Thank you. take a second to introduce the band up here. Over here on my left, your right, that's a tired joke, is Mr. Francis Bronson on the fiddle. Coming across the stage laterally, I guess Dow would be next. Back here on the drums, holding it down, Mr. Dow Cawthorn. Moving ever more in this direction, the next man is Mr. David Webb on the bass and vocals. Over here, what color is that, Jake? What would you say? Is that a cephone?
They call it surf green.
Surf green. On the surf green guitar. Yeah. Mr. Jake Smith. Got a couple more here. Thanks everybody for coming out and sticking around. My name is Samuel Quinn. Thank you. Something here.
Let's lay out. I'm gonna do the whole thing with raw dogging it first, third chorus. You come in on second chord, second verse.
Gotcha.
And then build it up. The drums will come in and solo after the second chorus.
Okay.
And then it'll come in big balls.
Big balls.
Yeah.
Just like my mom always says. So then come in like big balls.
Yeah.
This is for my mom. It's about, just kidding, my entire life's not a joke. This is not about my mom. This song's not about big balls. It's really easy once you start sliding that way. But it's not. In fact, it's about my dad and it's very serious. And it's not, it doesn't even have anything in common with AC/DC song matter.
But it's not gonna make me cry.
Mm-hmm.
spout. I hope this time she works it out. Was lying there. You told me you would go and get some help. You broke me down until I cried myself and tried to blame it on my hair. Do without it now.
Hey, thanks everybody. Thanks again to Second Rodeo for being on the bill. Thanks again to Clementine and Ron for being rad and letting us do all this stuff and coming out on church night.
Learning her, this does sound everything I needed. help.